Blessings, 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 beloved. I am Mama Pam, aka Pamela Dobson, and I read the word and or a book at noon, 7 minutes a day, Monday through Friday, so you don't have to read. This is the book we've been reading, He Who Finds a Wife. And during this corona season, the season where this corona thing just done taking the world by storm, we still got to live. I'm going to live. What about you? Brother man still looking for a wife, he might find him an internet bride. And ain't no telling what can happen during this season. So we want to stay in our posts. And my post is reading 7 minutes to encourage you to be the best you can in your marriages and to find your wife and to find a good thing and obtain favor from the Lord. We'll see a word of prayer and let's get into our read. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, Lord Jesus, one more time. And again, we thank you, we thank you, we thank you, oh God. Well, we thank you for this being another day that you have made where we choose to rejoice and to be glad in it. Lord, we choose to live in faith and not in fear. We choose to know that all of our needs will be provided by you, not by the government, but by you, oh God. Lord, we know that we will always have more than enough because you said that you would take care of your own. So, Lord, teach us, teach us, teach us, teach us during this season to humble ourselves and pray and seek your face, turn from our wicked ways. Then you promised you would hear from heaven, and then you would heal our land, oh God. Now, Lord, give the hearers of this read ears to hear what the Spirit of the living God says unto their clay, dirt body church. We are the church. The folks got it all twisted. They think they got to go to the building. We are the church where the Spirit of the living God lives, moves, and has his being if we invite you in and we allow you. Help during this season as people are shut up in these houses and the principalities can get real busy, but help us to realize we wrestle not against flesh and blood. It's not our son, our daughters, our husbands, our wives, but it's principalities, it's powers of spiritual wickedness in high places. You've given us power and authority to take a power and authority over those things, and we thank you for that. Thank you for healing me and making me every whit whole. Devil tried to kill me, but he couldn't. And I thank you. I give you glory, I give you honor, I give you all the praise, and I do call it done. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, resuming from Friday. So the point of that story and this section is to draw home the fact that God sees way beyond what we can prehempt, what we can... Oh, hold on. I set my timer. Austin jumped over to Periscope. Okay. God sees way beyond what we can comprehend in our limited view of things. He does not work within our logic, and we should not use our logic alone when making decisions in life. During this corona season, let's don't try to figure it out, because our logic ain't going to work. We got to trust God, y'all. So God knows what's best for us now and in the future. He knows what the final outcome is, even when things look like they're not going to work out in our sight. You might not know what's waiting around the corner when you walk the path he has laid out for you. But trust him because he does. Ooh, there's some good reading. God isn't going to tell you to do something only to set you up for failure. It may look bad at first, but if you know God is in it, then the final outcome will be far greater than you can currently imagine. It's in his timing. Another reason we struggle with walking on God's path is because we are impotent. Uh-oh. Impatient. When we want something, we want it now. We want to get out of these houses now. We want to go back to work now. We want to run to them church buildings now. And God said, not so. He said, go inside your house, close your door, and wait till this thing be passed. That's what he said. Our anxiousness and impatience will cause us to look for the quickest route to get it. However, many times what comes too fast will not last. It isn't always in our best interest to take the path of least resistance. However, this isn't anything we always realize right away. Many times it's not until later on down the road that it begins to make sense to us. It's tough to have to sit inside these houses and wait on something we desire so strongly or we don't understand. However, the waiting isn't the hardest part. The hardest part is not knowing when we will finally get what we want. And this makes the waiting worse. Isn't is something like this is written for what's going on right now, and we talking about a marital thing. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. God is so timely. If you knew you had to wait 2 months for a new job that would pay you more, and this was a guarantee, then it'd be a lot easier to be patient and wait for your time to come. So right now, if you locked down for 2 months, you got to wait. You don't know where you're going to go to work. Don't you know when you come out of this thing, it's going to be jobs or plentiful? Jobs that you used to want to get and couldn't get, they wouldn't let you. You're going to be able to get it, brothers, daughters. So just wait. Enjoy your family. Enjoy this season. Do you some tune-up. Go on the internet. Do you some classes. Do you some reading. Do you some YouTube videos. Learn how to fix your house. That stuff, the house falling around on you and your children. Learn how to screw a screw and fix the door and fix those things. Paint the house. Do something during this season. However, when you are waiting for that same job and there is no timetable and no guarantee from a non-spiritual perspective, well, then that wait can drive you crazy being inside these houses. During the waiting period, you're more likely to stray off your path and take things into your own hands. However, your hands were not made to control this situation or this corona situation if you truly want to experience the best outcome. Only God knows the most effective time frame for us to receive our blessings. He knows all the things that need to be done along the way. Hey, glory. He knows how every experience will shape your life and the lives of others connected to you. As difficult as it may feel to be patient, it is a must. Although you have to wait, the waiting period isn't about sitting back and doing nothing while you put it in God's hand. You still have work to do while you wait. To do nothing is like standing on God's path and not moving, expecting to reach your destination by a miracle of God bringing the destination to you. Faith without works is dead. So trust and believe that you have to do the work, which is how you actually walk God's path. Y'all got to do the work right now, and the work is pray, 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 pray. Pray, stay in them houses, love on your family, and pray, pray, pray. Do Bible study, read Bible study, do Bible drills, learn Bible verses. Get close to God during this season. This is a season of the trying of your faith and getting back to God. Because faith without works is dead. So trust and believe that you have to do the work, which is how you actually walk God's path. Don't worry about the distance. Just focus on your progress, no matter how small. As you continue to move forward in the right direction, you'll move closer and closer to what has been waiting on you all along. Remember, you're not really waiting on God. You're waiting on yourself to do what you need to do, the work, to get the blessing God has for you. There is a testimony in your trial. When it comes to God, He's not only our Father, but He's our teacher. He wants to provide for us, but He also wants us to learn how to use the tools He's blessed us with. This is how we access all that He has for us. There's no lesson in just sitting back as His hands use everything we desire. What greater purpose would that serve? It's like spoiling your children. They may be happy. You may enjoy putting a smile on their faces, but they will never learn the value of anything if they never have to work for it. May the Lord add a blessing to such a powerful, appropriate read for this coronavirus season. Trust God. Work on yourself. And wait. Isn't that what it was saying? It's talking about the demand to find a wife. But no, it ain't. God done turned this thing on these pages around to us waiting on the Lord during this season. Don't get haste. Prepare yourselves. Maybe, brothers, you wanted to do some more learning, some more schooling. Go online, do some real quick learning, real quick schooling. Get that wife, those children. Love on your children. Be a father right now in this season. Wives, be wives. Cook some home-cooked meals. You don't know how, go to Google. Go to YouTube. They'll tell you how to cook and how to do anything you don't know how to do. This is a season of us learning and perfecting our faith. I want to say thank you to all of you who have been supporters of the Smurf Ministry with your donation of $20 to paypal.me/PamelaDobson and or Cash App $MamaPam23. In this season that you are not able to go in those buildings, or even in this season that I have blessed you. I've been reading for going into 5 years. And my Bible tells me that a laborer is worthy of his hire. If I have blessed you in this season, during these 5 years, it's okay for you to be a financial blessing to me. I've never asked before, but we're asking now. Send any donation to paypal.me/PamelaDobson and or $MamaPam23. I love you. Have a blessed day.